All right, before we get started with our STEM project, I want to just review the engineering design loop again really fast. We looked at the poster. Read it with me. Here we go.
State the problem, generate ideas, select the solution, build the item, evaluate, present results.
Which one, show me with your fingers, which step is the engineering? Good, you should be showing me four, build the item. Okay, which one are you testing? Testing. Good, five, evaluate results. What about the brainstorming step? Two, you're right, that's generating ideas. Okay, work cooperatively, right? Working cooperatively means what to you, Emily?
Working cooperatively means that you work together as a team and don't argue.
Very good. Work together, be a team, don't argue. What does it mean to you, Emily? Leah?
It means to me that our group talks, we take turns talking, and we never just take control.
Take turns, don't take control. You're all even. No one is the boss. Right? No one is the leader. You all are equal on an equal playing field. What does it mean to you, Xander?
On an equal playing field, that means everyone gets to share their ideas the same way, and each person gets the same amount of credit. And each part of this project, if you're on an equal playing field, means every person will be.
Okay, I love it. You all get an opportunity to share, and you all get an opportunity to be heard, right? Everyone pools their resources and their ideas together. I love it. Okay, you ready for the problem? State the problem, step one? All right, let me move the slide. Okay. So, important part though, engineering, when you're engineering, right, and you're ready to solve a problem, engineers are given a finite amount of resources. Resources are supplies and materials, but if they're giving a finite amount, finite means, Bailey?
Not a very large amount.
Not a very large amount. What's the opposite of finite? Samuel, you want to give it a try? Large amount, infinite. Infinite means never ending. But engineers have a finite amount of resources, a small amount of materials, whether it's because they're limited on money or space or the supplies, right? When they have to complete a task. So what you're going to do is you're going to see the supplies that you have to work with, and you're going to fill out a planning sheet. Let me show you what that looks like. So we have our STEM planning sheet where you'll state the problem. Everybody in the group will write that down. Brainstorm ideas. You'll just do little jot dots, everyone's ideas. Your solution. This is where you'll draw the diagram of what you want to build, okay? And then this isn't showing on my screen, but then we have build it, and I'll give you a time frame on that. And then evaluate, that's where you write what happened, if it worked or not, okay? So we've done these planning sheets in the past. You know the way it works. You cannot start building until you have your problem written, your brainstorm ideas, and you kind of draw a little diagram of what you're going to build. A diagram is a picture with labels, right?
This is kind of what we had in our third grade.
Right, we've been doing these since third grade, you're right, okay.